Hi there. I'm going to take you through the group section on the teacher's dashboard in the PM eCollection. Once you're signed into the PM eCollection teacher's dashboard, on the left-hand side of screen are the six tabs to go through. We're going to go and select groups. In here, we'll be able to create classrooms, groups, and access and create classrooms as well. If you're new to this subscription, you won't have any classes available to select from. So we're going to start by creating a group or a classroom. First thing we need to do is name the group. If it is a classroom, tick the box. And we're going to add our students. This will give you a list of all the students that have a subscription to the PME collection. So go ahead and start clicking them and adding them to the group. We can then go OK. Now your students have been added to the group, and you also have myself, who has been logged in as the teacher because I've created it. You can add additional teachers if you like, whether it be an assistant or the AP, whatever it may be, you can go ahead and add them to the system. In this scenario, we're just going to leave it as myself. Once all that is done, you have the group name, you've ticked the classroom if that's what it is, we can go ahead and now create the group. And as you can see, Year 3 Magenta has been successfully saved to the classrooms in my groups. What we'll do now is go ahead and have a look what that looks like inside the class. So we'll view it. And as you can see, Year 3 Magenta, there are currently six members, so it'll include five students and one teacher. At the moment, we have a reading span of level 1 to 18. This is based on the students' profiles and their reading levels. How many books have been opened? So this shows a reading history, any recordings that the students have made, and any words that have been saved as well to their word lists. Again, it gives you a reading history of the students. There are two tabs here, reading history and students, which we'll get to in a minute. If we click yesterday, it will show you all the books that were accessed yesterday by a particular student. So it tells you which student has accessed those books. The Theo accessed Monkey Skateboard at 30th of March at 6:07 p.m. The book was open for approximately 23 seconds. One word was saved during that reading as well. The next book, which was Monkey's Big Bike, was on the 30th of March as well at 6:02 p.m. Theo saved one word in this reading. It was open for 22 seconds, and there was also a recording done by Theo. So what you can do is actually review this now. And now pulling this up will show you what page was recorded.
"Look at my bike," said Monkey.
And as we go on, we can see there's some more information of additional books that have been read during that time. You can review previous months as well with the students in that classroom. A nice feature just to notice, and I like to point out, is this one here was read by Theo Kitty Cat on the 2nd of March at 12:44. There were no words saved, and it also tells you how long the student had the book open for. So this actually shows you that Theo had the book open for less than 10 seconds. So it gives you an understanding that students possibly just opened it and closed it straight away. Although there is a recording, which whether that's an error on the student's part, but we can have a quick look.
Butterfly, he comes, kitty cat.
So the student was able to record something, however, it wasn't long enough for them to read the whole book. So if we scroll back up, you'll see there's the students tab. We're going to click that. And you can see every student that's in this classroom. Clicking profile will take you to the student section, which I previously have a video for, and will show you the sliding scale and information of the student's reading history. In this section of groups as well, what you will be able to do is edit the group and also print student cards. So when creating your classrooms, you will be able to create your classroom, and then individually, you'll be able to print off your student cards, which you can provide to your students, which has their username and password for them to take home. Again, we can edit the group. And for this purpose, it would be if a student has left that particular classroom, transferred schools, you want to add in an additional teacher or possibly change the name of your classroom. These options are available for you as well. We're going to go ahead and remove Catherine because Catherine has changed schools. So all we need to do is select her name and then click remove users from group. And you can see Catherine's successfully been removed from the group. We can then go ahead and save the group. And that is how to create groups in the PME Collection Teachers Dashboard.